All right, y'all, welcome back. We are in the first week of August and it is nostalgia t-shirt week. So that means any old t-shirts that you have from MAK, you can wear this week. I'm rocking this purple and green shirt. I wanna say this is from, it's gotta be like 2011. So like it's literally a decade old and I can't believe that it still fits and I can wear it. So can't wait to see all the nostalgia t-shirts that you wear this week to class. All right, let's get started as always with our student creed. So feet together, hands by your side. I'm a dedicated martial artist. Student creed begin. Aya, I must develop myself in a positive manner and avoid anything that could reduce my mental growth or physical health. Number two, Aya, I must develop self-discipline in order to bring out the best in myself and others. Number three, Aya, I must use common sense before self-defense and never be abusive or offensive. Number four, Aya, winners never quit, quitters never win. I choose to be a winner. Number five, Aya, this is a black belt school. We are dedicated. We are motivated. We are on a quest to be our best. So, ready, set, courtesy. So the star word or the black belt lifestyle word that we're talking about this month is responsibility. Say that, say responsibility. And what responsibility means is that we take ownership over the consequences of our actions. Every action we do has a consequence. So we do something and then something happens. That something that happens is the consequence. So when you're someone who's responsible, you hold yourself accountable. You have ownership over whatever consequence comes from the decision that you make. Whether that be a good or a bad thing in your perception. So an example of this is that your parents or your adults at home might ask you to keep your room clean or keep whatever space you have clean. If you keep your space clean, then you're allowed to watch an hour of TV every evening. If you don't keep your space clean, then you're not allowed to watch the TV for an hour an evening. So in order to have responsibility, you need to keep your room clean to get the consequence that you want, that good consequence of having an hour of TV. If you don't clean your room, you're gonna have that bad consequence of not having an hour of TV. So you wanna take ownership over making sure that you're responsible for cleaning your room. Someone who's not responsible would not clean their room and then they would, argue with their adult at home about watching TV rather than accepting the consequence. So your challenge this week is to be responsible. Think about your actions and what the consequences of those actions are and how you can hold yourself responsible. And sometimes our actions we might do something on mistake and there's a consequence for that. And that's okay. We still need to own the decisions that we make. All right. So that's the spiel about responsibility. We're going to keep working on responsibility all month. So I'm excited to have you learn and grow with that star word for the rest of this month. The other word we're working on this month is accuracy. Say that, say accuracy. And we will be earning our green stripe for accuracy. And the reason it's green is because we want to think about a plant and growing. What accuracy means is doing the move right and hitting the target. So all the rest of this month, we're going to be focusing on different techniques, focusing on how to do them right, and focusing on how we can make sure we're hitting our target where we need to. And another piece about accuracy and connecting it back to the plant is we want to get better and better every time we do a technique. We're not going to be perfect the first time we do it. We're also not going to be perfect the 50th time we do it or the 100th time we do it. Maybe by the 20,000th time you've done it, it might be kind of close to perfect, but we're always learning and growing every single time we do something. So we want to be thinking about how can we get better and better at doing the right thing the right way all this month. So we're going to do an accuracy drill. And when we go over everything, so our self-defense, our forms, all that stuff, we'll be thinking about how we can have accuracy. Okay, so for class today, we're going to need lots of props. So I need you to get 6 objects. You can pause the video in a second, but let me continue to explain. The 6 objects are going to be something that you spread out in the space that you're in. So hopefully you're in a space where you have enough room to lay out the 6 objects. If you are not, that is okay. You can get 2 or 3 objects and do this drill with the 2 or 3 objects and just double up. Instead of going to 6 different ones, you'll go to 3 twice. All right, so you wanna get something that is soft. I'm using 2 different boxing gloves that I have and another set of gloves that you wear underneath your boxing gloves for a total of 6 objects. And you want them to be something soft so that if you accidentally step on them, they don't hurt you. And if you accidentally step on them, you don't hurt it. All right, so like round things, probably not a great idea because you might step on it and roll your ankle. So pause the video, get your 6 soft objects and come on back. All right, hopefully you're back with your 6 soft objects or 3 if that's the space you have. What you're gonna do is lay out the 6 objects in a straight line. So you may not see all my 6 objects on the video, that's okay. Like for example, this first one's gonna be off camera. But you wanna lay them out so you have about your own hip's worth of space in between. You're gonna lay out your 6 objects. You can do this along with me or watch me and then pause the video, however you need to do it. See, I might go off camera again, and that is okay. So, you have your 6 objects. What we're gonna do with those 6 objects is a drill. It's called doing suicides. And what you're gonna do is you're gonna run to one object, do some sort of activity or what I tell you to do, essentially. Run back to the start, go to the next one, run back to the start, next one. So you do that 6 times. Or again, if you don't have a lot of space, you do it 3 times and then you do it 3 times again. But should look like that. I'm gonna show you the drills and then you're gonna have some time to do the drills on your own. All right, and remember, since we're working on accuracy, even if you get tired, you wanna still do the moves right. Because we wanna do the moves right so we can get better and better. Say that, say better and better. Let's get after it. So the first drill you're gonna do is a push-up. Now, I'm gonna show you how to do a black belt push-up, and I expect you to do a black belt push-up every single time you're doing this, because again, we're working on accuracy. So you wanna practice something the right way so you can grow, rather than practicing something the wrong way because it feels hard or because you're getting tired. All right, always do what you have to do the right thing. So I'm not gonna go exactly where my items are so that I can stay on camera and you can see me. But if you wanna start at your first item, you can certainly do that. So you're gonna start in the beginning. You're gonna run to your first item. I'm gonna run to my third one so you can see me on camera. And then you're gonna get in a push-up position. Now for a push-up, you want your arms straight out in front of you so that your arm is right underneath your shoulder, or your hands under your shoulder. We're gonna get on the floor in a second and hold this push-up position. When you bend your arms, or when you go down, you're bending your arms. See how my arms are bending? All right, that's what you're doing, but pushing up off of the floor. You don't wanna bend your back. You don't wanna use your body in that way. You want to bend your arms. You wanna keep your back as flat as possible. Now, we have natural curvatures, so there's gonna be some curve, but what you wanna avoid is looking like a mountain like that. All right, so let's get down, and we're gonna just do one push-up. Actually, just watch me do the one push-up, and then you can do the one push-up. So again, I'm in the push-up position, shoulders over my hands, I'm looking straight down at the floor. My back is relatively flat. I bend my elbows, go down, and push back up. Now, if that is too hard for you right now, you can get in this position and then put your knees down. You just put them directly down right underneath you, and you do the same thing with your arms. All right? I would much rather you go down to your knees and do a push-up like this, because that's going to still help you get the arm strength you need, than doing a lazy push-up like this or like this. All right? Because that is not the right way and not going to help you grow. So now that you know the expectation, you know how to do it right, you're going to do your suicide drills with push-ups. So you start from the beginning, your first object. Run to your first object. You're going to do three push-ups. One, two, three. Run back to your start. Go to your second object. Three push-ups. One, two, three. Run back to your start. Third object. Three push-ups. One, two, three. Run back to your start. If you only have three objects, go back to your third object and work your way back. If you have all six, go to your fourth one. One, two, three, and run back. So on and so forth. You'll have about a minute and a half to 2 minutes to get all six done. If you finish all six, go through it again. See how much stronger you can get and how much more you can grow. All right? Get after it. Don't stop doing what you're doing. Keep doing it. Keep on moving. Keep moving. Don't stop doing what you're doing. Keep doing it. Keep on moving. Hey, where the cash at? 100 miles in with a dash at. Please show me if the ass fat. Everything on me and that's facts. Sip, do say no, Chris. Shout it out at the video. Did you do your best? Now, I'm not there to see if you did your best. I don't know if you're lying or not. What's important is that you are honest with yourself, right? Because if you didn't do your best, if you weren't doing it right, you're not going to grow to your full potential. So keep that in mind as we move on to this next drill. And I encourage you to do your best and get better and better. So we're going to do the same thing with the suicides. So you're going to go to the first object back, second object back, third object back, so on and so forth, but with sit-ups. So we're going to go over and review how to do a black belt sit-up. And again, I'm going to stay on camera instead of going along with the objects so you could see me. So you're going to get down on the ground and you're going to plant your feet on the ground. Hopefully you can see. Feet on the ground, that's important. Legs are together. You're gonna put your hands either in an X across your chest, hold them up in a guard, or put them on your temples, which are the side of your head. You are not interlacing behind your neck because you can strain your neck that way. I'm gonna keep my hands in an X across my chest. You're going to push your feet into the floor to help you stay grounded, engage your stomach muscles, your abs, and you're gonna sit up like you have a string attached to your head and it's pulling you straight up. So when you do your sit-up, it looks like this. All the way up and all the way down. What I don't want to see is a lazy sit-up, which you could, you know, pull, use your penis to pull you up, you're grabbing your legs. All right, that's not right. You don't want to be flailing like this to sit up. You want to really push those feet into the ground. If you're not able to sit up all the way like this quite yet, maybe you just get to here and then you go back down. and you do that, you know your body best and you know what your best is, right? And if you're not quite sure what your best is, use this drill to kind of explore that, right? You can see how far you can push yourself and figure it out. Gauge where you're at, learn where you're at, figure out what your baseline is so that you know how you can improve and get better and better every time. Because again, these are things that aren't going away, right? Every stripe test, you gotta do push-ups and sit-ups and jumping jacks and all sorts of other things. Black belt test, you need to do push-ups and sit-ups. So work on them now, they're foundational things. If you do that and you figure out where your baseline is and figure how you can grow, you're gonna be getting the black belt test and it's gonna feel a lot easier than if you didn't put in that time and effort, all right? So this is round two of the accuracy drill. Same thing, you go to the first object, you're going to do 5 sit-ups though this time, okay? Run back, second object, 5 sit-ups, run back. Third object, 5 sit-ups, run back. If you have 6, go to 4. If you have only 3, go back to 3 and keep going. You're gonna have about the same amount of time. And again, try to get all the way through. And if you do get all the way through, keep going and see how far you can go. It actually would be awesome is if you do complete more than one set, have your adult put it in the comments underneath this video and tell me how many extra times you did it. Or tell me how you, what something you learned and grew upon during this drill. All right, let's get after it.
Soon as the moonlight hit, we came alive like a 2-live skit. In Brooklyn, they call it Midnight Mitch. The moonline rule, the bass gon' hit. Clap, clap on the floor, she a dancer. Black skin so smooth like a panther. Hair long, I get up a pom-pom. The booty so dumb, can I get some? She smile when the Bluetooth hit. Like at the views out the window, can't YouTube it. Girl, I see you next Friday, we got Ice Cube it. And I'm thinking like Morty, but I'm more like Rick. Damn. It's T.L. and Luke is the child. Who is the squad? Who wanna style? I be LeBron and he be the brow. Keep moving on, can't stop us now.
And we're going to do a front kick. So we're going to go over foundational, what a front kick needs to look like so you know how to do it right. And then you're going to do your suicides with the front kick, all right? So we're going to get in our guard stance. Yeah. When we do a kick, shout out in the video if you know it. How many parts are there to every kick? Go ahead, say it. There's 4. If you said it, awesome. If not, now you know, now you can grow. 4 parts. Those parts are chamber, kick, re-chamber, down. Say that with me. Say chamber, kick, re-chamber, down. All right, and so we're gonna use our back leg. When we do a front kick, we wanna turn our hips from our guard stance sideways to face the bad person, all right? So I move my hips, so they're facing the bad person, bringing in that rotation from last month, right? We rotate our hips. That first thing we do is a chamber, so go ahead and do this along with me. You're gonna take your back leg and just bring it up like you're stepping on a step. Bring your knee up as high as you can. Balance, it's okay if you have to put it down and put it back up. All right, and then you're gonna land forward, just like that. So now your belly button's facing a new way. And back. I lied. We're not gonna land forward because it's more challenging to land backwards. So that's what we're actually gonna do. So we're gonna do chamber. Bring your leg, you're stepping on a step. Balance, whoop, and then bring it back. All right, so instead of stepping forward, let's step back. Let's do that one more time. So chamber, hold it, and back. Now we're gonna add the kick. So we're gonna kick straight out and work on accuracy. So we wanna think of what part of the foot we're kicking with. So if you lift your foot up, do this with me, touch the underneath your toes where your foot is. That's called the ball of your foot. That's the part you're kicking with. Say that, say ball of your foot. All right, so now you know. So you're gonna turn your hips, chamber, kick with the ball of your foot, re-chamber, and put your foot right back where it started, all right? So just watch, it's gonna look like this. Yeah. All right, do it along with me every time I count. Ready? One, yeah. Two, yeah. Three, yeah. Four, yeah. Five, yeah. Good, now let's switch your stance. Same thing on this side. Don't forget all four parts, right? Chamber, kick, re-chamber. Don't forget to re-chamber. Don't be lazy. Because remember, we're learning to do it right so we can continue to grow. Guard stance, your left foot should be in back. We're doing a back leg front kick, putting it right back where it started. Ready? One, yeah. Two, yeah. Three, yeah. Four, yeah. Last one, best one. Five, yeah. And time. So now what you're gonna do, same thing, those suicides, you're gonna get in your guard stance and you're gonna do five kicks, five back leg front kicks on each one. All right, so you're gonna go to your first object, put your right leg in back, do five front kicks with accuracy, and then run back. You're gonna go to the next object, same thing, keep your right leg in back, do five front kicks with accuracy, go back. Do all six objects or your three twice, and then you'll have a little bit more time this round because you're gonna do it again with your other leg. All right, so you go through all six objects once, kicking with your back leg as your right leg, and then you're gonna go through all six objects again, kicking with your back leg as your left leg. All right, five kicks every time with accuracy. Are you up for the challenge? Say, bring on the challenge. Go get it. So we're moving on to forms. We are going to go over part A, the whole entirety of part A this week. Next week, we'll go over the whole entirety of part B. Week three, we put the whole thing together and then it's strength test again. All right, so this week again, we're putting part A together and doing the whole thing. Since we're working on the accuracy and doing it right, what's gonna happen is I'm gonna break it down in detail. I'm gonna tell you a lot of little things for accuracy. See what you can pick up on that's new for you, right? Because you've already tested on the whole form, really. Month one, which was June, I believe. Yeah, June, you learned part A. Month two, which was July, you learned part B. And now in August, we're gonna be putting them together. So you know this. I say all that to say, think of a way that you can grow and get better. Pick out one thing that I talk about today that you're gonna focus on the rest of this week when you're practicing your form, how you can improve. Some general things you could think about are your stances. Are you someone who has really awesome stances, or can your stances be improved a little bit? Even if you have really awesome stances, how can you improve them a little bit, right? Because even when you get to black belt, I've been a black belt for some time now, I can still improve upon my stances. There's always things that you can learn and grow on. Maybe it's your kicks. Maybe it's your kia or your intensity, right? You're having that mean face. You're showing your seriousness in your body. I don't care what you pick. Just pick something to grow. All right? Keep that in mind. Let's get to it.
All right.
All right. We're really getting to it now. Okay. So we're going to start with our feet together. Hands by our side. Action karate form three, part A. Man, and remember, we're in a horse stance, not a guard stance. So we're going to jump our feet out. As we do that, we're pretending someone behind us and we're elbowing them. So we go like this. Ayah! All right, and in your horse stance, you want to have your knees kind of look like the corners of a square, a 90 degree angle. Your legs are bent, your back is straight. This is a lazy stance. All right, it's a house stance. Kind of looks like the roof of a house with your legs. This, that's too much. That's, my back is bent. This is like a squat or a frog stance. You want to be in between those things to have accuracy. All right, a horse stance. Now move number one, we're gonna go towards the left. So you're gonna take your right hand, you're gonna bend your left leg, the right leg becomes straight, your right hand blocks an object in front of you and makes an X. That right hand's on top of the X. That's move number one. Move number two, that same right hand's gonna do a knife hand strike to the front. Move number three, we're gonna go back into our horse stance and then continue so that we bend our right knee, our left leg is straight, and then our left hand does that block in front, nice and slow, up into that X block, so left hand is in front. Move number four, you're gonna do a left hand knife hand chop. And then we're gonna go to move number five, which is where we start part B. We're gonna take our left leg, move it up to touch our right leg so our feet are together. And we're gonna do that cup and saucer on our back hip. And we're gonna freeze there. Remember, I'm gonna come close so you can see. A cup and saucer, we're thinking of like a little tiny plate and a teacup on top. Our right hand and back is the saucer or the cup, or the plate. Our wrist is towards the ceiling and it's on our hip. Our left hand is the cup, it's on top. So our wrist is facing down and it goes on top and it's on our back hip. That is our cup and saucer hidden technique. All right, so those are the details. Let's go through it by the count. And then you're gonna have some time to practice and pick out what details you're gonna really focus on this week, all right? Feet together, hands by your side. Action karate form three, part A, man. Horse stance, Thea. One, two, three, four, five, and set. Victory, humility, courtesy, man.
Younger, no one ever could tell me how to live my life. I started trouble, that's what young kids do, and I was young, alright. My teacher said I'd be a failure. They called my mama just to tell her, oh, your son is trouble, there's no doubt. He's never gonna leave this town. Well, mama, look at me now. Catch me waving from the sky in a brand new G5. Mama, look at me now. Said that kid was on slide, but he's doing alright. Mama, look at me now. Mama, look at me now. Mama, one ever could tell me how to live my life. I told my mama not to worry, cause she worried about my world outside. They gave me pills to make me better. They called my mama just to tell her, oh, your son is trouble, good for nothing, he ain't ever gonna leave this town. Well, mama, look at me now. Catch me waving from the sky in a brand new G5. Mama, look at me.
So we're going to review our self-defense, and then like your form, you're going to have some time to practice it with accuracy. So our self-defense is hidden sword. Say that's a hidden sword. Because this weapon that we use to strike our attacker is like a sword. We want to think about our pinky as the blade of the sword. So someone has their hands around your throat like this from behind. All right, so imagine someone's choking me like this. I'm the one standing here getting choked. I'm gonna turn sideways. I want you to do this along with me. Hopefully I'm in camera view. Hands up, I don't want any trouble. The first thing we're gonna do is hide that sword. So our left hand comes towards our right ear. We're gonna take a baby step with our right foot. Remember, we don't wanna take a big step forward because then we're choking ourselves more. We're leaning into the choke. It's just a baby step to help us with rotation. Then the next thing we're going to do is we're going to turn and strike the hands out of the way. Then we're going to throw a punch with our right hand, and we're going to kick with our right foot. And then we're going to cover out. We always cover out. How we cover out is we want to keep our eyes on the bad person. We take the foot that's closest to them. We step away from them by putting it in front of our other foot that was in back. Then the foot that's now in back steps out. And then again, keep your eyes on the bad person. You want to step around and get into a guard stance. So those are the details. Let's go through it a little quicker. I'll just say go and we'll do it together. Hands up, I don't want any trouble. Go, baby step, hide the sword. Turn and strike, punch, kick, cover out. One step, two step, yeah. And time. So now you're gonna have about 2 minutes, maybe a little more, maybe a little less, to practice your self-defense. Think about how you can grow and get better and better. Maybe it's you're visualizing your attacker a little more. Maybe it's you're moving through quickly. Maybe you're making your cover out even better. Pick something to grow, focus on that, and get practicing.
Feels warmer sleeping here alone. You know I dream in color and do the things I want. You think you got the best of me, think you've had the last laugh, but you think that everything good is gone. Think you left me broken down, think that I'll come running back. Baby, you don't know me, cause you're dead. What doesn't kill you makes you stronger. Stand a little taller. Doesn't mean I'm lonely when I'm alone. What doesn't kill you makes a fighter.
with our principles of being a black belt. So feet together, hands by your side. I'm a dedicated student of the martial arts. And I live by the principles of being a black belt. And they are integrity, concentration, perseverance, respect and obedience, self-control, humility, indomitable spirit, knowledge, power, black belt, courtesy. Give yourself a hand. Excellent work today.